not out of the question. What can I do for you, George?
Several moments, Alex remained. He studied his hands, small and deep. Not the hands of a murderer at all, he said. Then he looked up. Look for a good guy, Bradley. Bradley was surprised by this. He didn't have out of the guy. Alex nodded.
Too late, even now, not quite. Insanity defense is rarely successful after the fact, Mr. Bradley. He won't call me Len, Bradley thought. Not even after all this time. He'll go to his death calling me Mr. Bradley. Rarely isn't the same as never, George. No, but I'm not crazy now. If I wasn't crazy then, I was never more sane. Are you sure you want to hear the testimony I wouldn't give in court? If you don't, that's fine. But it's all I have to do. Well, of course I want to hear, Bradley said. He picked up his pen, but ended up not making a single note. George Harris spoke in a soft voice. good dad. He was a mining engineer and worked mostly in the Southwest until I was 8. A housekeeper traveled around with us. Her name was Mona McCarthy, and I called her Mama Mooney. She was black. I suppose he slept with her, although when I slipped into her bed, which I did on many mornings, she was always alone. It didn't matter to me, one way or the other. I didn't know what black had to do with anything. She was good to me. She made my lunches and read me the usual bedtime stories when my father wasn't home to do it. And that was all that mattered to me. It wasn't the usual setup. I suppose I knew that much. But I was happy enough. In 1977, we moved east to Talbot, Alabama, not far from Birmingham. That's an army town, Fort John Hill, but also coal country. My father was hired to reopen the Goodluck mines, 1, 2, and 3, and bring them up to environmental specifications, which meant breaking ground on new holes and designing a disposal system that would keep the waste from polluting the local streams. We lived in a nice little suburban neighborhood in a house the Goodluck Company provided. Mama Noni liked it because my father turned the garage into a two-room apartment for her. It kept the gossip down to a dull roar, I suppose. I helped him with the renovations on weekends, handing in boards and such. That was a good time for us. I was able to go to the same school for 2 years, which was long enough to make friends and get some stability. One of my friends was the girl next door. Or a magazine would have ended up showing our first kiss in a treehouse, falling in love, and then going to the junior prom together when we finally made it to high school. But that was never going to happen for me and Marley Jacobs. Daddy never led me to believe we'd be staying in Talbot. He said there was nothing new than encouraging false hopes in a child. I might go to Mary Day Grammar School through the 5th grade, maybe even through the 6th, but eventually his good luck would run out and we'd be moving on. Maybe back to Texas, New Mexico, maybe up to West Virginia or Kentucky. I accepted this, and so did Mama Noni. My dad was the boss. He was a good boss, and he loved us. Just my opinion. But I don't think he can do much better than that. The second thing had to do with Marley herself. She was, well, these days people would call her mentally challenged, but back then the folks in our neighborhood just said she was soft in the head. You could call that mean, Mr. Bradley, but looking back on it, I think it's just right. Poetically, she saw the world that way. All soft and out of focus. Sometimes, often even, it can be better. Again, just my opinion. We were both in 3rd grade when I met her, but Marley was already 11. We were both promoted to the 4th grade the next year, but in her case it was just so they could keep moving her along through the system. That's how things worked in places like Talbot back then. And it wasn't like she was the village idiot. She could read a little and do some simple addition, but subtraction was beyond her. I tried to explain it every way I knew how, but she was just never going to get it. We never kissed in a treehouse. We never kissed at all. But we always held hands when we walked to school in the morning and back in the afternoon. I imagine they looked damn funny. I was a shrimp and she was a big